for us, we know that they will fundamentally create a city with lifestyle and livability that will attract those businesses of the future, so that their people no longer have to live where they are required to work, but work where they choose to live. So we want them to choose to live here in Bunbury because of the lifestyle and livability that we offer. PricewaterhouseCoopers has estimated we're going to lose between 40 and 50% of the jobs in the primary industries that predominantly make up the jobs in regional Western Australia, as well as regional Australia more broadly. So what we're proposing is to do a program of diversifying regional WA here, focused on creating the industries now to drive the transformation of those traditional industries so that we retain those jobs here and we make those new industries competitive on a global market. A digital city is where you have the need and the capability in terms of the technology and infrastructure alongside those individuals, organisations, universities and research capabilities to actually sit alongside those people in those industries and create the opportunities and the solutions here in context of the region. It's really hard for researchers and universities where they are based in a capital city to work alongside those industries in the regions and create those opportunities really dynamically. You really need them to co-locate to create the true opportunities for innovation into the future. So a digital city is where you have those able to provide the solution alongside those that need the solution in a space that is enabled with the technology and infrastructure required for Industry 4.0. Bunbury is amazing, and we really had to ask ourselves, why Bunbury? What's special about Bunbury? And when you look at the Bunbury geograph and the southwest as an area, Bungeo supports a population of around 104,000-107,000, and Bunbury actually holds 42,000 jobs, and it drives $270 million worth of economic value through tourism. It's got an amazing lifestyle and livability, and it's really in a Goldilocks zone between the other major population centre of Busselton and Perth and the Peel area. It's also uniquely positioned in terms of all of those primary industries and all of that core transport infrastructure, such as a port, both outer harbour and inner harbour, the southwest interconnect system, so the power grid, and how that disperses energy throughout the region. It already has a large investment of government services and private service and industry providers. And we've already got a lot of the technology infrastructure here in Bunbury. So it makes a lot of sense that you would create that regional hub of capability here and allow that to be accessed and drive the economic future and opportunities of the inland primary industries and the down south tourism and events areas of Busselton and Margaret River. And what a great place to live if you've got all of that within 30 or 40 minutes of your doorstep. So Bunbury is very, very unique, not only in WA, but actually across the whole of Australia where it has all of those things on its doorstep. The future of a digital city is that we fundamentally need people to want to live here. The space in which the city of Bunbury plays and the things that we choose to do as a city and where we choose to put our investment in terms of our ratepayers' money is into improving the lifestyle and livability of the city. The digital city is a concept, and that is our identity for being the second city of WA. So if they turn around and say, second city of WA, Bunbury, and they say, go, what do? Where do we put our money? Well, we're saying that that goes into the digital city concept. It goes into investments to remove the technology and infrastructure barriers so that companies like Commonwealth Bank or Telstra can run their call centres here. That's great for us as a city because we diversify our community and we create jobs of the future for our kids. We're looking to get those universities here, and what a great place for postgraduate studies in artificial intelligence for our kids to come and do their educational journeys here and start their early careers here. All of these things go to creating a vibrant community and a vibrant city of the future. And what can we all contribute to that? We can do everything we can to make it the most livable city in regional Australia and the most accessible regional city in Australia. The more we we put into making our city livable, and the more people want to live and visit and invest, the better it will be.